Okay, we have seen the least upper bound property. Least upper bound property of R. You can see here. It says that given any non-empty bounded subset of R, then there exists alpha belongs to R such that if it is bounded above, actually these are axioms. मालूम है axioms किसे कहते हैं? Axioms. Actually, these are acceptable. You can say statements based on which we will do further reasoning and arguments. So in mathematics, those things are called axioms. So it says this one you can also called as upper bound axiom or least upper bound property. Similarly, parallel to it, there is a lower bound axiom that if your non-empty subset is bounded below, then you will have infimum. So it says that. So this condition is always true in case of real numbers. We will see that we have seen that real number. Whenever we take any bounded non-empty subset of R, we have taken any bounded non-empty subset of R, suppose it is bounded below, then it always have a supremum, and if it is bounded below, then it always have an infimum. Okay. And if it is bounded below as well as above, then it will have infimum as well as supremum. So you can see here that this I explained you that all those collection of all those rationals satisfying x square less than 2. So on simplifying, you will get that basically this set is collection of all those rationals lying in minus root 2 root 2, or you can also write it as minus root 2 root 2 intersection Q. Now if we consider, now question is that any set is said to be satisfying least upper bound property if every non-empty subset of it has infimum as well as supremum. But to discard, now in place of real numbers, I have taken Q, the set of rational numbers, the set of rational numbers. Now question is whether set of rationals is also satisfying this least upper bound property. So if it is not satisfying least upper bound property, then you need to produce at least one subset of Q which is bounded above and has no supremum, or which is bounded below and has no infimum, or which is bounded and has no supremum as well as infimum. So this is a very good example here that the set Q of rational numbers is not satisfying this one, because see here I explained that this set is bounded because it has various bound. I mean, 2 is this bound, 3 is its bound, upper bound. So clearly this set is bounded above as well as bounded below. So in general, this set is bounded. But supremum of A does not exist. Supremum of A does not exist. Reason is that actually its supremum in R is root 2. It's okay. But supremum in Q does not exist. So I have produced a bounded subset of Q which has no supremum, bounded above subset of Q which has no supremum. So this is the reason why set Q of rational numbers is not complete. You can say is not, basically this one is called as completeness property of real number. So in today's class, we will see some other examples. And one more example I have discussed here. Let me once again recall that example. So you can consider this set of rational numbers A as a subset of Q. So again, this one is a counter example. If you simplify this x square greater than 2 and x square less than 3 and take intersection of all this, then you will find that this set is root 2, root 3. And we are looking for, since A is subset of Q, so obviously x will belongs to Q. And you can write here root 2, root 3 intersection Q. Root 2, root 3 intersection Q. Just simplify it, x square minus 2 greater than 0, you will get this one. So x greater than root 2 and x less than minus root 2. And similarly, if you simplify x square minus 3 less than 0, then you will have this factor. All rationals lying in between minus root 2 to root 3, sorry, minus root 3 to root 3, and for x greater than 0 and x greater than 0. Am I audible to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now look here. Because question is that whether this set is bounded set. Yes, this is clearly bounded because you can see that its upper bounds are 4, 5. All these are its upper bound. Its lower bounds is 0, minus 1, minus 2. So it is, if there exists at least one upper bound and at least one lower bound, then we always claim that and bound should be from Q, because we are talking in the space of rationals. So everything we will look in set of rationals. Now question is that does A has infimum in Q and supremum in Q? So this one is, so you can see that if you take intersection of all this, then this one is the common portion. This one is the common portion here. I mean, all rationals lying in between root 2 and root 3. That is what written here, root 2, root 3 intersection Q. Now you can see that set of all upper bounds of A is all rationals lying in this one. So I mean, starting from root 3, whether you on root 3 you put closed interval or open interval, it will not matter, because after taking intersection with Q, it will not be in there. So there are various upper bounds, you can see, in fact countable upper bounds, because we are taking intersection with Q and Q is countable. But I am not using here these words, because still I have not taught you this countable and uncountable set. Later on, after covering that, I will. And similarly, set of all lower bounds is given by this one, minus infinity to root 2 intersection Q. So here, actually, if it is asked that what is its supremum, infimum in R, then it's okay. Its infimum in R is basically this one, root 2, and supremum in R is root 3. But here it is asked that what is its supremum in Q? That it supremum in Q will not exist, as well as infimum in Q will not exist. Now, how to discard that? How to discard? Yes.
Screen sir, share कर दीजिए sir.
Screen is already shared.
No sir, आपकी screen नहीं दिख रही. No sir, not visible. Oh.
तो अब वो बोलना चाहिए था, मैं भूल गया, मैं screen share करना. Anyway. Let me in short one explain once again, because these two are very important example. Like I cannot ignore this. Actually, problem here is that this one is a very important result which differentiates set of rationals with R. Later on, I will also discuss the properties of this ordered field and all this ordered field. We will see that Q is also an ordered field, R is also an ordered field. But the extra part property that R is a complete ordered field and Q is not a complete ordered field. I mean, Q is not complete. So how to claim that Q is not complete? Here, what I'm trying to say, just look at also the previous results and then we will. In short, I'm recalling, I have explained here that this one is the least upper bound property of R, and you can see that given any non-empty subset of R which is bounded above, then there exists its supremum. Whenever a set is bounded, these all properties are for set of real numbers. So whenever a set is satisfying completeness property, this is also called completeness property of R, or any set, if it is satisfying completeness property, then every non-empty bounded subset of that set must have supremum as well as infimum. And if that set is bounded only above, then it must have supremum. And if that set is bounded below, then it must have infimum. So this is the least upper bound property, provided it is ordered. Obviously, we will talk. Yes. So here my claim is that the set Q of rational numbers is not satisfying least upper bound property, or is not complete, in fact, you say. The reason is that if it is not complete or not satisfying least upper bound property, then we need to produce at least one subset of Q which is bounded, I mean non-empty subset of Q which is bounded but has not supremum, which is bounded above but has not supremum, or which is bounded below and has not infimum, or if it is bounded, then it will not have infimum as well as supremum. So you can see that here, this one is a very good example here given in your book. So you can see that because we are looking supremum and infimum in Q, so clearly this set is bounded because 2, 3, all are its upper bound. and we are looking all rationals in this interval. So because our space is now Q, not R, I am talking in Q. So the claim is that so using law of trichotomy, one can discard that it has no supremum. That I will explain in the next part. Just have a look on this question, which we have discussed yesterday, I mean in the previous class. So consider your space as Q, set of rationals, and take this subset. Claim is that Q is not complete. That is, it is not satisfying the least upper bound property, LUB. So my claim is that, yes, first of all, simplify this set. We have taken a subset A of Q, collection of all rationals. Obviously, A is subset of Q, so I don't need to write here because our space is now set of rationals. So if you simplify x greater than 0, x square greater than 2, and x square less than 3, then after simplifying x square minus 2 greater than 0, you will get this one, minus root 2 is greater than x is greater than root 2. So it will be basically right to root 2 and left to root 2, the region left to minus root 2. Similarly, if you simplify the second one, minus root 2, 3 to root 3, so it will be basically this region. I mean, all rationals lying in this region, minus root 3 to root 3. And x must be greater than 0. So basically, the common portion is this one, collection of all rationals in this region. So I can write this set as root 2 to root 3 intersection Q. I can write this set as root 2, root 3 intersection Q. So the question is this set bounded? So yes, it has many upper bound as well, lower bound. You can see 3 is also its upper bound, 4 is also its upper bound, and lower bound 0 is its lower bound. And you can see that minus 1, minus 3, all these are its lower bound. So if we have at least one upper bound and at least one lower bound, then clearly this set is bounded. In fact, the next question is, does A has infimum in Q and supremum in Q? Here it is not asked in R. So we are interested to find infimum in Q and supremum in Q. So to claim that Q is not complete, I need to see any number system is said to be complete if every non-empty bounded subset of that set must have infimum as well as supremum. And if it is only bounded above, then supremum. And if it is bounded below, then infimum. So look at the set of all upper bounds. Set of all upper bounds is collection of all rationals, which is lying in this neighborhood. So what I'm telling that if you put a closed interval here in place of root 3 or open interval, it will not matter because we are looking for the set of rationals. Our space is set of rationals. And similarly, the set of lower bounds is this one, minus infinity to root 2 intersection Q. Minus infinity to root 2 intersection Q. So you can see here that again, root 2 is not there because we are looking at the rationals. But all other rational numbers lying in this are its lower bound, and all rationals lying in this one are its upper bound. So clearly this set is bounded. Now, claim is that this set A will not have infimum as well as supremum in Q. So how to discard it? In short, I tried to explain in the last moment of the lecture. Let us relook this one. Suppose beta is its infimum. Suppose beta is infimum of the set A in Q. Then what will happen? This is your set A. Basically, your set A is root 2, root 3 intersection Q. We need to find the infimum of this set. So suppose beta is infimum of this set. So as per definition, if beta is infimum of the set, then every member of the set, I mean, whatever be the set A is, whatever X you will choose from this set, X will be always less than equal to beta. This is the definition of, we have assumed infimum, so it will be right to it.
ये supremum के लिए हो
जाएगा। हाँ, ठीक है बिल्कुल। Okay, so whatever X you will consider, I mean, this set may be, I mean, finite, infinite, but here it's already given. So whatever set we are choosing, root 2, just for example, root 2, root 3, and look at all the rationals lying in this region, root 2, root 3. So suppose beta is its infimum. Then what are the possibilities? Suppose actually our claim is that beta infimum will not exist, but look at, just assume that suppose contrary to it beta will exist, then we know that not only set of rational numbers, set of real numbers, set of rational number is also satisfying law of trichotomy. That ordered and that property I will explain in another lecture, because already you have studied all those things in algebra, so I have not, but quickly I will revise those things, that why it is an ordered field, Q and R, whereas C is not ordered. I will discuss. Okay, but we know that here. So what are the possibilities for this infimum? Either see, beta is less than equal to x, where x belongs to it. So you can see here that beta, this either beta will be equal to root 2. So some possibilities we have, either beta will be equal to root 2, because see, beta is a rational number. Beta is a rational number. We are assuming because infimum should be from Q, so obviously beta is a rational number. And beta is, either beta will be greater than root 2 or beta will be less than root 2. So this is not possible, the first one, because beta is a rational. We are looking infimum from Q and root 2 is an irrational number. So first option is discarded. Second option, beta is greater than root 2. What will happen? Look, beta, if beta is here, I mean greater than root 2, then we know that between every two rational, in fact, between every two real number, there lies infinite rationals. So if beta is greater than root 2, suppose this beta is right to root 2 and not equal to root 2, then obviously there are members from the Q which at least you will get at least one member from the set A which is less than beta. So it will discard the definition of infimum. समझ में आया कि नहीं? इनफीमम क्या कहता है? इनफीमम सेट के हर मेंबर्स के या तो इक्वल हो या उससे छोटा होना चाहिए. अब बीटा अगर रूट टू से ज्यादा हो गया तो आपको मालूम है रूट टू और बीटा के बीच में दो रेशनल नंबर के, ये क्या है, रूट टू के राइट में, और रूट थ्री से पहले अगर बीटा आप ले लो तो उसमें, उस केस में क्या होगा? यू विल गेट एटलीस्ट वन मेंबर फ्रॉम द सेट ए व्हिच एक्सीड्स बीटा. सो व्हिच एक्सीड्स बीटा, सॉरी, at least one member from the set which is less than beta, which is less than beta. So it violates this definition. Diagram se dikh raha hai. So this is the reason why second, this condition is also not true, because it will violates your assumption, this one. I mean, it will not remain infimum, because infimum bhi to ek tarah ka upper bound hai, lower bound hai na. So, among all lower bound, you are choosing the greatest one. And why this beta less than root 2, why this one is not possible? Look at the number line, right? To, because this is the advantage in this one, in R or subset of R, root 2, root 3 intersection Q. Here you are looking all Q belonging to Q. This is your set. Now, if beta is less than root 2, then what will happen? This one is a real number. This one is a real number, root 2. So in between every two real number, there lies infinite rational numbers. And you are claiming that beta is infimum. So if it is infimum, so among all lower bound, it should be the largest one, but you are getting other rationals, say Q dash, which is greater than beta. So thus beta will not remain infimum. I mean, then Q dash will remain infimum. So this is the reason that none of them will hold. So in general, infimum in Q does not exist. Same argument you can use for supremum. समझ में आया आप लोगों को ये चीज? इस पे सोचो ना, जब सोचो और फिर अगर डाउट हो तो डिस्कस करो.
यस सर.
देखो आपको डेफिनेशन जो है ना वो वायलेट कर, आई मीन, सो लेट मी राइट ऑन द नेक्स्ट पेज हियर. ये सब एग्जांपल इसलिए समझा रहा हूँ क्योंकि ये अगर नहीं समझोगे ना तो आपको सब सिंपल रिजल्ट रटने से कोई फायदा नहीं होगा. आप कोशिश करो समझने की कैसे लॉ ऑफ ट्रिकोटॉमी को कैसे इंप्लीमेंट करना है, कैसे ऑप्शंस को डिस्कार्ड करने, ये चीज आपको आनी चाहिए. कोर्स बहुत ज्यादा नहीं है, मैंने इसीलिए आपको तीन चार स्टैंडर्ड बुक बता दिया, आपको सब कुछ इसमें मिल जाएगा और कंपटीशन में इससे बाहर सवाल नहीं आते. अगर आपको ये जो कुछ की क्वेश्चंस करा रहा हूँ इसकी अंडरस्टैंडिंग डेवलप हो गई तो आप कोई भी कंपटीशन में बैठो, यकीन मारो मेरा हर क्वेश्चन सॉल्व होगा और रियल से क्वेश्चन बहुत ज्यादा आते हैं. सो Now let me write this. In fact, let me add page to this one. Continue with this one. So you can see that. In fact, quickly I will revise some of the things. Let me write here its definition also. So I can say that right here, a number system is said to be complete if every non-empty bounded subset from the number system which is bounded below as infinite and if it is bounded above then it has supremum and it has supremum in the number system. इन द नंबर सिस्टम ठीक है ना तो ये देखो डेफिनेशन कंप्लीट का क्या है व्हेन वी से दैट अ नंबर सिस्टम इज सेड टू बी कंप्लीट इफ एवरी नॉन एम्प्टी सबसेट फ्रॉम द नंबर सिस्टम व्हिच इज बाउंडेड बिलो इफ इट इज बाउंडेड बिलो इट मस्ट हैव इनफिमम एंड इफ इट इज बाउंडेड अबव इट मस्ट हैव सुप्रीमम एंड इफ इट इज बाउंडेड इट मस्ट हैव इनफिमम एज वेल एज सुप्रीमम तो ये डेफिनेशन है सो यू कैन सी दैट आर satisfies number system R satisfies completeness property whereas Q doesn't satisfy completeness property completeness axiom ठीक है डाउट तो नहीं किसी को यहां तक
नो सर
ये तो मालूम है ना क्यू ऑर्डर्ड फील्ड है लॉ ऑफ ट्रिकोटोमी होल्ड करता और एवरी नॉन जीरो एलिमेंट हैज मल्टीप्लिकेटिव चलो मैं एक शॉर्ट में रिवाइज करा दूंगा आर एंड क्यू ऑल दीज आर ऑर्डर्ड फील्ड बट नॉट द डिफरेंस हियर हाउ यू विल डिफरेंशिएट आर एंड क्यू सो दिस इज द डिफरेंस दिस डिफरेंशिएट कंप्लीटनेस प्रॉपर्टी इज प्रेजेंट इन क्यू आर Whereas completeness property is missing in Q, so thus we have differentiated Q from R. Q को हमने R से differentiate कर दिया. चल कुछ और example देखते हैं. तो एक काम करता हूँ. पहले तो देखो आपकी जो book है ना उसके exercise में बहुत से questions दे रखे हैं. लेकिन चलो उससे आने से पहले भी अब एक काम करते हैं कि पहले कुछ और questions कर लेते हैं. थोड़ा सा मैं और short में recall करा दूँ. देख लो आप चीजें revise कर रखी हैं कि नहीं. चलिए मैं आपसे कुछ पूछता हूँ अलजेब्रिक स्ट्रक्चर किसे कहते हैं व्हाट वी मीन बाय अलजेब्रिक स्ट्रक्चर
सर अ सेट विद बाइनरी ऑपरेशन एनी सेट एनी नॉन एम्प्टी सेट विद वन और टू बाइनरी ऑपरेशन वन और मोर बाइनरी ओके
सर इफ इट इज क्लोज्ड अंडर एडिशन एंड मल्टीप्लिकेशन
ठीक कह रहे हैं आप लोग कुछ पढ़ा है आप लोगों ने तो चलिए सर जल्दी मैं रिकॉल करा देता हूँ और कुछ एग्जांपल्स भी हम लोग देख लेते हैं अलजेब्रिक स्ट्रक्चर हालांकि ये सब चीजें आपने पढ़ रखी उधर तो अब रियल में मैं बहुत ज्यादा इन चीजों पे क्योंकि आप लीनियर अलजेब्रा में भी पढ़ते हो, ग्रुप थ्योरी में भी पढ़ते हो, मैं क्विकली रिकॉल कर रहा हूँ. सो नॉन एम्प्टी सबसेट, जस्ट राइट हियर, नॉन एम्प्टी सेट विथ वन और मोर कंपोजिशन compositions or you can say operations or maps defined on it is called an algebraic structure. Or algebraic system. So if A, suppose A is the given non-empty set. And say this one is a composition defined on A. Then the algebraic system is denoted by A with say this operation. For example, R is the set of real numbers. You already know that. This we already know that algebraic structure, that R with its usual addition and multiplication is an algebraic structure with two compositions. I am not going to deal it in detail, just I am recalling that that real number system is an ordered field. We know that real number system is an ordered field. So how you will claim that this one is an ordered field? So suppose R be the set of real numbers and two binary operation. Here I am talking with respect to usual addition multiplication, but in general this operation can be, I mean this in place of R, in general it can be any set. And here those two binary operation we will denote by addition and multiplication, but in case of R, here plus and dot denotes usual addition and usual multiplication. So we know that with respect to that algebraic structure satisfies the following field axioms. ठीक है ना, वो कौन कौन से field axioms satisfy करते हैं? First one is addition के respect में क्या क्या होता है?
Commutative,
associative.
Associative, commutative.
Very good. Addition के respect में addition axioms क्या क्या होते हैं? पहला, for every a b belonging to set of reals, a plus b must belongs to
b plus
a. Addition के respect में क्या होना चाहिए? Closed होना चाहिए ना, closure law of addition. Similarly, commutative law of addition. सब आप पढ़े हुए हो, मैं शॉर्ट में लिखता चला जा रहा हूँ. फॉर एवरी ए बी बिलोंगिंग टू आर, ए प्लस बी इज इक्वल टू बी प्लस ए. पहले वाले को क्या कहते हैं? क्लोजर लॉ ऑफ एडिशन, है ना, क्लोजर लॉ ऑफ एडिशन. सेकंड वाले क्या कहेंगे? कम्यूटेटिव लॉ ऑफ एडिशन. ऑल दिस आर विद रिस्पेक्ट टू एडिशन, कम्यूटेटिव. थर्ड, associative law of addition. ठीक है ना, associative. I am not going to write here because just I am recalling. You know all that existence of additive identity, existence of
additive identity,
additive identity. How to write it in quantifiers? That is, for every a belonging to reals, there exist zero belonging to R such that
A plus zero is equal to zero plus A is equal to A.
I have taken my set restricted. In real number system, we will study about reals and its subset. And this zero is called additive identity of R. Zero is basically additive identity of R. Similarly, and what are the with respect to multiplication? And fifth is the existence of additive inverse.
Additive inverse.
Existence of additive inverse. So whenever we have identity here, I can talk of additive inverse. That is, for every A belonging to R, there exists some B from the set of reals such that
A operation B is equal to zero.
And A operation B equal to identity, or say B operation A, because already it's commutative. And similarly, and the multiplication, what are the multiplication axioms? I mean, with respect to R plus and dot, quickly let me recall multiplication axioms. Mohammed, don't do this. I will remove from the group. Everyone write your roll number while entering the okay. So multiplication axioms, you can call the first one as closure law of multiplication. That is, for every AB belonging to set of reals, A operation B belongs to R. Operation here stands for multiplication, if operation. Second, commutative law of multiplication. Multiplication. That is, for every AB belonging to R, what A dot B is equal to B dot B operation A. A operation B, and operation A stand for multiplication operation. And third, associative law of multiplication. So you already know associative law. We can continue. Fourth, existence of multiplicative inverse. Existence of, sorry, multiplicity. First of all, we will talk of identity and then inverse. Existence of multiplicative identity. What is that? For every A belonging to R, there exists one belonging to, we know that multiplicative identity is one here, one real number one, because if you multiply it to any real number, it will produce the same. So it is satisfying that criteria. And the fifth one, So one is called the multiplicative identity of R, and existence of multiplicative inverse. Multiplicative here operation is with respect to, we are talking multiplication, multiplicative inverse. So we know to write it multiply, I mean, given any A belonging to R, where A is non-zero, there exists B belonging to set of reals such that after taking composition with multiplication, you will get identity. And identity is one. So all these things, that is in general A operation, B is equal to B operation, A is equal to identity. Okay. So all these things you will know. And in general, multiplicative inverse in symbolic form, someone also used to denote A inverse like this, or in some form like this. And the next is distributive property. So distributing multiplication distributes over addition. This already you know that multiplication distributes over addition. So third here is distributive. So multiplication distributes over addition. In R, because I am talking here about real number system R. So for every, that is for every A, B, C belonging to R, for every A, B, C belonging to R, A dot B plus C is equal to A dot B plus A dot C. So with respect to all these properties, no. So a non-empty set with at least two elements in it with two binary operations satisfying all the above 11 axioms. Total 5, and here previous to this, if you look at here, we have 5 properties on the previous page. 5 properties here, 5 properties on this one. Please mute your mic.
इतना बढ़िया है वो चारों तरफ से खुला हुआ है हवाई हवाई वहाँ
अरे भाई माइक बंद करो
Okay, again, if I will find anyone writing on this page, then I will remove from the group without giving any warning.
Sir, agar binary operation plus and dot le liye, to closure property likhna zaruri hai. Dono ka meaning to same hai, sir.
हाँ वो एक ही बात है, वो हमने लिख दिया है ताकि नाम से पता नहीं क्यों इस पेज पे नहीं जा रहा प्रॉब्लम कभी हैंग भी करता है ना ये सिस्टम डिजिटल चलो नेक्स्ट सो टोटल देर आर 11 प्रॉपर्टीज एंड यू कैन सी हियर दैट So you can see here that those, if any set with at least two elements in it, a non-empty set with at least two elements in it and with two binary operations satisfying all the above 11 properties is called a field. Okay, now so I'm not able to write on that page exactly, but that one is basically definition for field. all those 11 properties is for field. Now question is, what is ordered axioms? What are ordered axioms? Because in general we used to say that R is ordered field, whereas C is not ordered field. एक बार वो मैं दोबारा शेयर करता हूँ, स्टॉप करके, कुछ प्रॉब्लम हुई है, हैंग कर रही है. Okay. So let me write here ordered axioms. Order axioms. These are the so order in ordered axioms. The first one is trichotomy law, and the second one is transitivity. There are total four properties. So let me write the first one. First one is that for every A, B belonging to R. Exactly one of the following holds. Already I told you, but let me write it exactly. One of the following holds. Exactly one of the following holds. That is, either you can call this one as ordered axiom. So you can call this one as A1. So the first property is A is greater than B, or A is equal to B. Or A, B is greater than A, or you can in general say A is less than B. So this is the first property. This is also called as law of trichotomy. So there are four properties. If a set is said to be ordered, if it satisfies all these four conditions. Second is that for every A, B, C belonging to R. In general, I have taken R as a R. This stands for set of reals. So, for every A, B, C belonging to R, if A is greater than B and B is greater than C, I mean transitivity property passing over. This implies A is greater than C. So you can call this as transitivity. And the third property, A3. That is for every A greater AB, for every AB belonging to R, A is greater than B. This implies A plus C is greater than B plus C for every C belonging to R. For every C belonging to R, this is called monotone law of addition. Monotone law of addition. Monotone law of addition. And the last one is for every A, B, C belonging to R, A is greater than B, and if C is greater than 0, this implies AC is greater than BC. So here operation is multiplication, A operation C, B operation C. So this is known as monotone law of multiplication. Monotone law of multiplication. So basically this one is the requirement for a field, for a set to be called ordered, for an algebraic structure to be called ordered. These are the requirement, these four conditions. So you can see here that a set of real number, if a field satisfies all the these four order axioms, then we called it as ordered field. So let me write here that if a field satisfies all order axioms, all four order axioms, then it is called an ordered field. चलें तो ये तो डेफिनेशन मैंने लिख दिया, वेरीफाई कर लेते हैं. आपने पीछे जो चीजें पढ़ी जरा रिकॉल कर लेता हूं मैं. सो वी नो दैट इन दिस वे द सेट क्यू विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू यूजुअल एडिशन एंड मल्टीप्लिकेशन इज एन ऑर्डर्ड फील्ड. किसी को डाउट है? इज एन ऑर्डर्ड फील्ड, वेयर एज ऑल्सो आर विथ respective addition and usual addition multiplication is also an ordered field. But what differentiate them? That is the completeness property, completeness axiom. We have seen that Q is not a complete ordered field. Both are ordered field. Q and R both are ordered field, but Q is not a complete ordered field. Why? Because Q is not satisfying the least upper bound property. I mean, you can to claim that Q is not satisfying this completeness property, you can have a non-empty subset of Q, which is bounded but has no supremum or infimum as per the case. I mean, if it is bounded above, then it will not have supremum. So if we are able to produce at least one subset, non-empty bounded subset, then we will say that Q, this number system, is not an complete ordered field. This one is an ordered field, but not a, so this property differentiates us. Now field axioms, a set of rational numbers, I am not going to prove that set of rational numbers is following this field axioms, that you can, because already you all these things you have studied in your group theory and this linear, in the starting of linear algebra, especially in group theory. Here my question is that, now let me come to some questions based on this one, on these properties. ठीक है ना, उसके बाद फिर combined questions करेंगे. So let me ask you some questions and check how many of you have better understanding of all these things. Okay, let me move to the next page and ask you some general questions. So a number system is said to be algebraic structure if it is closed with respect to addition and multiplication. Okay, so what about natural number? Is a natural number is an algebraic structure?
Yes, sir. So for any rational number, it proves all the axioms.
Yeah. Let me write it. Set to be an algebraic structure if it is closed with respect to addition and multiplication. And for field, you need to follow all those 11 properties. That is, for every A, B belonging to A, I mean A plus B, this can be usual or this may not be usual. Here just plus stand for addition and multiplication. And, हाँ क्या बताया? Yes, anyone? कोई doubt है किसी को? Okay, now what about rationals? So rational number तो आपने पढ़ा है, कोई भी दो rational number है उनका sum करेंगे again, rational number of the form p by q. So again say p1 by q1 or and second number you can choose p2 by q2 where q1 q2 are non-zero. So their sum is again of the form some p dash by q dash. ठीक है, तो rational numbers क्या होते हैं? I mean for every, तो ये सब आपको verify करने जरूरत है. Rational numbers with respect to usual addition and usual multiplication, basically they are the form algebraic structure. उसी तरह natural number भी क्या है? Natural number, set of natural numbers with respect to usual addition and multiplication is going to form algebraic structure. Algebraic structure. तो ये सब आपने पढ़ रखा, मैं इसके डिटेल में जाना हूँ. व्हाट अबाउट रियल्स? रियल्स में भी देखा, दो रियल नंबर्स का सम और मल्टीप्लिकेशन क्या होता है? अगेन अ रियल नंबर. व्हाट अबाउट कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर? कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर में भी दो, आई मीन कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर ऑफ द फॉर्म ए प्लस आई बी वेर ए बी आर रियल. सो वेन एवर यू मल्टीप्लाई टू कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर or add to complex number, again you will get a number of the form a plus ib. So again this, all these are for basically algebraic structure. All these are algebraic structures. तो इसमें कुछ ऐसा था। व्हाट अबाउट सेट ऑफ इरेशनल्स? देखो किसके रिस्पेक्ट में पूछा जा रहा है ये इंपॉर्टेंट। व्हाट अबाउट सेट ऑफ इरेशनल्स, आई मीन क्यू डैश, इज दिस एन अलजेब्रिक स्ट्रक्चर? यस एनीवन, इज दिस एन अलजेब्रिक स्ट्रक्चर? चलो मैं चेक तो कर लूं, इज दिस एन अलजेब्रिक स्ट्रक्चर?
नो सर।
व्हाई, कौन सा ऑपरेशन इसको फेल करेगा?
सर एडिशन, 2 प्लस रूट 3 एंड 2 माइनस रूट 3।
वेरी गुड, 2 प्लस रूट 3, यू कैन टेक दिस वन एज अ कॉम्प्लेक्स इरेशनल नंबर एंड 2 माइनस रूट 3। सो यू कैन सी दैट 2 प्लस रूट 3 प्लस 2 माइनस रूट 3 इज इक्वल टू 4 इज नॉट इन, एंड सिमिलरली यू कैन ऑल्सो चेक दिस वन, रूट 3 इंटू रूट 3, बोथ आर कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर, सॉरी बोथ आर इरेशनल्स बट देयर प्रोडक्ट इज नॉट एन इरेशनल। So I can say that not an algebraic structure is not an algebraic structure. पहले तो algebraic structure होगा, तब तो आगे जाके field की बात करेंगे, है ना, तब तो आगे वो 11 properties देखेंगे। Anyone? What about non-negative integers? I mean r minus n. Okay, what about non-natural numbers? Set of non-natural numbers. Yes, anyone? What about this?
No, sir.
R minus n with respect to usual addition multiplication. कोई बताएगा कोई काउंटर एग्जांपल?
सर मल्टीप्लिकेशन
यार माइनस, आई मीन नेचुरल नंबर हमने निकाल दिया, ये ऐसे लिख सकते हैं, कुछ बुक्स में आप ऐसे लिख सकते
हैं सर, 1/2 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 3/2।
वेरी गुड, हाँ ठीक है, 1/2 मल्टीप्लाई
फ्रैक्शंस, सो वी कैन टेक फ्रैक्शंस इन इट।
नो
नहीं सर,
ऐसे ले लो ना, 3/2 ले लो, 2/3,
3/2 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 1/3,
हाँ 3/2 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 2/3,
2/3।
तो देखो क्या आ गया, ये 1 एंड 1 इज नॉट मेंबर ऑफ r / n, ठीक है, सो दिस वन इज नॉट एन अलजेब्रिक स्ट्रक्चर। What about this set? This set say 1, 3, 5 and all this with respect to usual addition and multiplication. Is this an algebraic structure? Anyone?
No, sir. 1 + 3, 4.
Very good. No, 1 + 3 no, equal sir. To 4. No, you no, can sir. Call this set as B. So 1 + 3 = 4 and 4 is not in B. ठीक ना, discard हो गया, ठीक, इसका तो आपने चीजें पढ़ रखी है, very good. What about this set? R minus 4 with respect to usual addition and multiplication. Unless I state, we always assume it as usual addition and multiplication. Is this an algebraic structure?
Yes, sir.
आप लोग बताएं सर, पढ़ा हुआ है आप लोगों को, ऐसा कुछ भी नहीं जो नहीं बता सकते इसमें।
Yes, sir.
हाँ, is this an algebraic structure?
Yes, sir.
क्यों हो गया?
No, sir. Sir, 1 + 3, 4 हो जाए। Sir, 1 + 3 does not belong to R minus 4.
Yeah, 1 + 3 = 4 does not belongs to R minus. तो हम लोगों ने देख लिया कि ऑर्डर होने के लिए लॉ ऑफ ट्राइकोटॉमी, लॉ ऑफ ट्रांजिटिविटी और मोनोटोन लॉ ऑफ एडिशन एंड मल्टीप्लीकेशन ये फुलफिल होना चाहिए। अगर ये फुलफिल है तो हम क्या कहेंगे उसे ऑर्डर्ड। अब आते क्वेश्चन, मैंने आपको ऑर्डर्ड बता दिया, अलजेब्रिक स्ट्रक्चर बता दिया, फील्ड होता है क्या वो बता दिया। अब आते हैं कुछ क्वेश्चन,
माय क्वेश्चन सर, कैन वी लीव, वी हैव अनदर क्लास सर।
यस यस, दोज हु आर नॉट फ्री यू कैन लीव। I will take 10-15 minutes and will share recorded lecture, don't worry. Now my question is this set, is R minus 0 a complete ordered structure? Okay, so I will continue in the next class. I'm stopping here and we will see various examples based on this. So question is R minus 0 complete order structure? I'm not talking of algebraic structure. So if this is not complete, obviously it's an ordered structure. If it is not complete, then you need to produce a non-empty subset of this set. Which lacks supremum or infimum. Okay, I will discuss all these things in next class. ठीक है, ये रहने देते हैं, अब next class में इसको discuss करेंगे, क्योंकि अब आप लोगों की अगली class है तो leave कर दें, next class में मैं discuss करूँगा।